Hello and welcome back to City Skylines. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Vanilla. That is both the series and the city, which I suppose is more of a town at this point, but that's fine. It's doing all right. We have 6,849 people. We get more stuff at 8,500 people, which includes trains, which I'm super excited about because it would be really nice to get a train, cargo train terminal into here, even if it is just temporary, you know? That'd be real, real nice. What I'm also going to do is buy this tile here because I'd like to do something about this traffic at some point. But I think my focus for today is going to be on making sure that we can get a lot of money and making sure that we can hit our milestones, because milestones are pretty important. They are. Even though, you know, the game is, it's a simulator, it's a city simulator, and it's a beautiful game, you can make beautiful things. This is vanilla, so we don't have those mods, we don't have creative mods in the slightest. We don't have anything. No traffic management mods, no nothing. So what we have to do is make some serious bank, and then get in to making everything look pretty. So what I'm doing at the moment is going ahead and capping off the industrial zone a little bit with some roads that are going to cut through the space. I'm also going to go ahead and do something similar just over here. I'm going to pause while I do this though, because this is a chain. Oh, wait a minute. No, that's fine. That is completely fine. We're going to cap some roads off there. I'm going to get rid of a little bit of industrial zoning, about 4 tiles worth of industrial zoning from there. And these pathways in here are also going to go. And that's because I want to try and help traffic a little bit. So what I'm going to do is that road's going. Not completely. I'm going to put them back in to a point, that point specifically, so that buildings can still be zoned on these roads up to the same space that they were before. But this way, traffic has to come into the city a little bit, and it also means that we don't have these roads connecting directly to the sort of avenue entrance. I'm going to get rid of that road completely because there's not really anything I want to change with the residential space here, so get rid of you. We'll keep that park over there. And I'm just going to go ahead and expand the commercial zoning a little bit, just right up to the road that I've put through that whole space. So there we go. That's going to be absolutely beautiful. Hopefully that'll help traffic, because most of this you're seeing here is industrial traffic. And there are other solutions. I've toyed around with the idea of putting a roundabout in here or some kind of junction that'll take industrial traffic over to here, but I don't necessarily want to do that. That's not really something I'm interested in doing. What I will do, though, is go ahead and just fill up all of this space with more industrial zoning. Just every bit of it, like so, and all of that too. Those guys are going to need some serious water as well, so let's just bring that over to there. And over to there, and bring you over to there, and bring this over to that spot as well. Okay, so those guys are all going to have water. We do need to demolish that building. We are having some serious garbage collection problems. That is quite simply because we absolutely need more garbage incinerators. So we're going to go ahead and get another one right there. And we can't afford another one, unfortunately. They are 30,000 each, so we're going to be waiting a little bit for that. But another incinerator should absolutely help the city. So let's hope that that is the case. As for industrial traffic, I'm really not sure what to do with it. I'm really not sure because, I mean, it's cool and all that it's, you know, so keen to get where it's going, but we just have so much of it. And I really don't want to make an ugly little junction here that's going to take industrial traffic over to here, because not all of the traffic's going to be interested in using it, so I don't know. I think what I will do is put another bit of a focus on education, because we have 1,400 people interested in high schools. This can only hold 1,000, but I think a high school might be a really good bet. It would also be nice to maybe throw into this neighborhood over here. I think that's something I'm going to do. I'm also going to get rid of this road here, because as you can see, traffic backs up a little bit because of these tiny junctions. So get rid of these guys here and bulldoze their buildings, and then just connect this road straight through like that. I feel like that's fine to have. That's a decent connection. It kind of makes sense. little tiny junction here. But other than that, I think this kind of makes sense. It stops traffic from backing up horrendously at this point here. So we'll do that. I'm also going to go ahead and I think just bring this road through here. Because I could maybe, just maybe, put a high school on that. Which I think would be kind of cool. Because it puts it right in, yeah, it puts it right in the residential space. And right next to a whole bunch of houses. It's a nice neighborhood, I think. So I quite like that. What I'm also going to do is just de-zone sort of the back few bits of these guys' houses. So that I can decorate the high school just a little bit. Because it isn't the most pleasant, let's be honest. You need to get out. There we go. So that guy's house has been got rid of. You can go as well. And these trees all need to kind of go as well. There we go. So let's just get those guys out and get rid of that tree. Get rid of that tree. And a couple more of the trees just there. And what I'd like to do... Oh, that's a little buggy. Let's maybe fix that. And just bring this road to about there instead. Maybe a little bit further. Can I get it to go just perfectly to the end of... Yeah, there we go. Much better. Less buggy, which is what we want. So, what I'd like to do is come in with some trees. And I'm just going to sort of plop a couple of trees at the end of the road and just here and there. Just to make that road a little bit nicer. I think a couple of rocks could be really good too. These are $10 each, so that's fine. We'll just sort of throw them just in like this. Just to kind of make this space look nice. And I know this isn't a creative focused series, but just a few rocks here and there to just spice the place up a little bit, you know? Just to get some rocks into detail and all that stuff. Looks kind of nice, especially with that little kind of hill thing we have going on. These just look interesting and like a bit of decoration. Even if these are just temporary. Again, a lot of what we're building is possibly temporary. This little suburb maybe less so because it is a little bit further away from the initial battery of buildings that we had. But, you know, it's very possible that in a million episodes time, I will want to change a lot of this. So we'll see. I'll put that big tree in there. I'll put a slightly smaller version of that tree in there. I'll get one of these trees just in there and one of these ones in there. And just get a few trees white to make the area look slightly alive. And even that is just a nice little touch. And I like it. I do. I'll put a couple of trees just there as well. One of those and a nice big tree sort of there. I think it just looks good. You know, just a little bit of vanilla decoration. You don't have to have a million and one mods in City Skylines to make something that looks kind of cool. So there you go. Even though this area is quite bare, we can fix that eventually. What I will do, though, is turn off snapping on you, and I want to just bring a little sort of... I'm going to say a dirt path, I think. Sort of just around the back of the school. Just sort of like that, and then maybe... Kind of come across there, perhaps? I don't know, maybe it just continues sort of along here. Because there's not really much else I can put into this space. So bringing a little dirt path through there is kind of cool. I kind of like it. You know, it's a little pathway that people can take to get home a little easier or something. You don't have to go on the main roads or whatever. I can also put some trees along it, which will make it look like it belongs a little bit more. So do that kind of thing. Get a couple of these trees just along this little pathway, which I think looks nice. Something like that. Get a nice big tree in there and in there. And a couple of these slightly lighter trees along the pathway as well. Just make it look nice, you know? Just a little bit of detail. A couple of rocks could go in there. I think what I'll do is I just want to very loosely line this side of the school with some hedges to make it look like it does have an actual end to it and isn't just a big patch of concrete that someone's abandoned, because it looks a little silly. As it is. So just do this kind of thing the whole way along the side of the sky. I just can't help myself, can I? Seriously, I start up a vanilla Let's Play series and we're building something. We're just doing a little bit of design. I really can't help it. Unfortunately, this thing I'm doing with the hedges is going to sort of just have to end here because there's a big area there I can't do anything with, so that's unfortunate. I'll put a tree at the end. And I'll put a couple more trees just in here and there to make it look a little bit more built up. This will look pretty good once there's some houses built in front of it as well. But yeah, I think that's quite nice. I do. I think that looks You know, it's simple, but it's effective, it does what it does, and more to the point, that gives us more education for the entire city, which we're going to need, because we do have the ability to put in some high-density commercial and high-density residential and some offices, but we don't want to do that yet, because we don't have anyone in the city that is necessarily highly educated, so we're not going to bother with that just at the moment. We could also look into putting a roundabout here, but I kind of like the little four-way intersection. It is inefficient, but a roundabout would be even more inefficient because we'd have to use the highway roads, and you can't do those in a small scale, which this is. And these would work, but again, they're a bit funky. So basically, we're going to have to stick with this. Like I said, if I use highway roads, it won't work. If I use these roads, it's going to create a bunch of traffic lights around the roundabout, so we're not going to bother with that. And immediately, so many people going to school. That's so good. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to turn on the day-night cycle. I haven't played with that in a while. Use the day-night cycle. I'm not going to turn on dynamic weather because that's, well, boring. But did I apply that? That is on, right? Gameplay, day-night. Yeah, it's on. All right. So the day-night cycle's on, which will be cool. I'll leave it on for the rest of this episode. I'll let you guys, you know, throw some feedback in, see what you think of the day-night cycle. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't. That's all well and good. Do I have bus lines? No. No, I don't. Okay. We should get some buses in here. Because I think buses would be quite cool. This guy is still emptying, 57% full. There are fewer garbage problems across the city, that's for sure. But not few enough. So I think I'm going to go to budget. I'm going to take a loan. We have this one already. I'm going to take another one. Because I can get myself another incineration plant. And I'm going to move this one a little bit, I think. What the hell? Are they? Yeah, they are even. You know what? Actually, I'll just keep it there. It's fine. Another incineration plant knocks us up into the yellow for incineration status. So I think we're doing okay there. Traffic's still backing up a little bit, but that's okay. How are things over here? You guys don't have water. That's not even a piping issue. That is just a water availability issue. So we're going to need to go and get ourselves another water tower, which I will just throw in there and connect up like so. So that should solve our problems, which it does. Beautiful. I am honestly really pleased with this. This is something I never tried in Vanilla City Skylines. I never tried making something that looked kind of pretty. And I know this isn't, you know, anything spectacular, but it's just nice, you know? It's a nice little bit of detailing which just makes the area look pretty. Get a couple of hedges about there. To make the area look a little bit alive, all that stuff. Put some hedges around the rocks and all that. Just again, to make the area look like there's some flora about the place. Not the butter or the fake, but it's not actually butter, is it? Flora's not butter. By the way, if you don't know, I don't know if flora as a brand exists outside of the UK. So anyone that's sitting there going flora, well, no, it's not butter. It's a plant. It's a type of like fake butter over here in the UK. Why am I talking about butter? It's a City Skylines video. Jesus. Let's just get some rocks about there. Get some more plants in. There we go. That looks so pretty. Also, I haven't seen City Skylines at nighttime in a long time. So I'm excited about this. It doesn't look like we have any abandoned buildings about there. We do have a few in the industrial zone, which is a problem. Because again, we need to bulldoze those. I did see a couple of people requesting that I just turn on auto bulldoze as a mod. I'm not going to do that. And the reason I'm not going to do that is because of the way I actually enable no mods in City Skylines. I don't go through my content manager and turn them all off. I use the launch option through Steam. If you right click in City Skylines and go to properties, you can go to launch options and you do like the little dash, little minus symbol, dash no workshop, all one word. And that basically disables the Steam Workshop in City Skylines and takes out all of your custom stuff. That way, this is much, much easier to do alongside things like Emerald County. And my God, that's pretty. That is so pretty. Hold on a minute. Cinematic camera? Oh my God. This game is... Look at that. It's a terrible little... It's not a good build at all, but it's so pretty at nighttime. Then this little high school, which for some reason has people in it at nighttime. Still very pretty. A lot of people using this little pathway here, by the looks of it. That'd be terrifying at night on your own. And the orange... Oh, the orange lights of this! It's so good. I love it so much. I really do. It is a little bit crap for Let's Plays, though. Because you can't really see what's going on. So, maybe we will turn that off again. I gotta see how pretty it was. I'm gonna turn it off again, because you can't actually see what's going on. This hasn't actually been zoned yet, so we're gonna want to do that. So, zone that up. And, the garbage problems are going away. There is demand for commercial zoning, so... Maybe, just maybe, what we'll do is go ahead and expand this over to there and bring it down to there. Get rid of the pathway. And we'll go ahead and just throw some commercial zoning into that space. Which I think could be quite nice. So that way, we have a little bit more commercial zoning coming in. There is a bit of a demand for residential just creeping up there. This space here is probably not gonna stay, to be honest. Because I like the idea of moving all my low-density residential out to here, and I don't think this is the design I want to go for high-density. So we're probably going to move a lot of my low-density out to this space. Which, to be fair, this space is still building. There is still a lot of free space out here. So we're probably okay. There are also some small... There was a small crime problem right here, but I'm pretty sure, yeah, the police have been to the house and had a look and said, hey, cut it out. Cut it out. Right now. No crime. No crime here. Oh. Now this is a problem. This is definitely a problem. Maybe we should look into a different way of doing this. So maybe this little connection here can stay. And this one here next to the... Unfortunately, I'm going to have to get rid of my absolutely flawless decoration. We're going to turn this into a little road with a little avenue with trees on it. And we're going to do the same... I feel like this bit's fine, to be honest, that little bit, because it's connected up here as well. And then I think I'll do the same just here. Just like that. So there's a few different connections about there to get into this space. And this way, traffic will hopefully be able to flow just that little bit better. Because I think having everything sort of based off of one central point was maybe a bad idea. Still decent demand for commercial, which is surprising. I would like to come in here, though, and change this to a one-way system. So the traffic basically all just flows... The whole way around, counterclockwise, like that. So yeah, traffic can just flow counterclockwise around that little space and go where they need to go. Which I think will be nice. I also need to put a little bit of commercial zoning just there. To fill out that space. Also, there's the star of the last thumbnail. Right there, there's the star of the show. I think you can imagine that this will probably be the star of the show for this one. Unfortunately, there's not a good angle of it. Yeah, it's not in sunlight. I might have to turn the day-night cycle back on to get this thing in sunlight. Because it is not at a good angle at all. Yeah, that's just lots of shadows. That'd be terrible for a thumbnail. Look at that. That's terrible. That's utterly terrible. I mean, this angle's okay, but... I mean, that's a lot of trees. That's a lot of trees. There's a lot of trees. Although, that's okay. That's not bad. You know what? We'll just grab that one. That might work. I don't know. We'll soon find out. I kind of just want to outline the building though. No, that's not going to work. I want the front of the building. Never mind. We'll get that later. It's fine. Let's actually get on with the video though. So, we do have demand for commercial. I think this little expansion here was apparently not enough. So what we'll do is... I'm going to go ahead and do this. And bring that the whole way across. So these guys do have water. And I feel like industry is something I maybe want to start getting rid of. There's a lot of abandoned industrial buildings, so I feel like I have too much of it at this point. So I'm going to cut industry out of there. So all that space, I'm actually going to cut it out of here as well, and then move the power plants out of the way. So these can actually go down next to the incineration plants. I feel like that's probably a pretty good place for them. So they can go just there. And that means we can cut all this stuff out of here. It does cause some issues with electricity for the sewage outflow. But we can totally fix that in just a second. We'll get rid of that line. We'll go ahead and run another one from there to there. There we go. So that industrial zoning is all gone. I think what I'm going to do, actually, is I'm just going to very quickly de-zone all of my industrial space and just let it all disappear. Every single bit of it, except for, obviously, the buildings we've placed. All of the abandoned buildings, gone. There we go. So that's all gone. What I'm not going to do is zone just like this. I'm just going to rezone it and let it all rebuild nice and fresh, nice and clean, nice and beautiful. Up to that point. In fact, yeah, just up to that point is fine. I'm doing that just because I want to see exactly how much industrial zoning we actually need, because I don't want to have too much of it. And a nice little refresh for the industrial zone could be exactly what it needs. So we'll see how that goes. Hopefully very well. Hopefully that was a good thing to do. Obviously not going to be zoning up here for a while because there is a lot of pollution, but we can deal with that eventually. Gonna get rid of that little pathway there. And I mean, that might work out. It's definitely going to cut industrial traffic into the city for a while. It definitely hurt our income, which is for sure. Income is not good at the moment. It did take a bit of a dip, but it is, you know, the industrial stuff, it's rebuilding slowly, and it's going to build exactly what it needs. And then if this whole area gets filled up and it says, hey, we need loads more, then I'll add another row or two of it and see how things go. So that might end up being a pretty good tactic to keep the industrial spaces working the way I'd want them to work. Hopefully. We'll absolutely see. Now, what I'd also like to do here is perhaps start changing these residential roads a little bit. This one can't really be moved because there's 103 people stored here. So we can't really do that. But I kind of like the idea of maybe just putting them on angles and then changing them to high density. But that's risky considering the fact that I did just really hurt my income and there is no residential demand right now. So maybe I don't want to do that. Maybe that's a terrible idea. It is probably a terrible idea. I think what I'll also do is go ahead and start connecting the ends of these roads together so that people can easily get about and easily head up to the avenue if they so desire. We might see people be inclined to walk to high school as opposed to anything else. We could also, if we really wanted to, we could extend a dirt road, a dirt path, just temporarily, from over here to here. And people might cycle. That would be cool. I would love to see people legitimately, like, cycling from all the way over here to high school. But I don't know that it's necessarily going to happen. Is anyone even going to the avenue there? Doesn't look like it. There's no one really walking on it, so it kind of makes sense that there wouldn't be anyone going from here to it anyway. That's fine. That's fine. We have no demand for anything. This is a very familiar sight for me in City Skylines, having no demand for anything, because I built a lot, didn't I? I built a bunch of industrial zoning that no one really wants. We have demand for, you know, commercial, which I think we could start placing because the pollution is actually clearing up. So we'll go ahead and add in just a little bit of commercial zoning. I would kind of like to add it up to about there and see how that goes. And then maybe we'll add in just a street of commercial zoning. And that'll hopefully be enough. That might incentivize people to want to start moving here as well. Because obviously, they're going to move where the jobs are. And there is currently demand for jobs. So people might start moving here because of that. You guys are having some crime issues, which were just solved by officer police car. Okay. Well, I'm not going to judge a name. That's not how you spell officer. There we go. That's officer police car. Beautiful name. It's a beautiful name. He decided to, you know, carry that name on. That's the burden he has in life. He's going to carry that name through life. A little bit of demand popping up for residential there, just very briefly. A little bit for industrial, so I imagine the industrial zone is almost full. Commercial filling up a little bit there as well. Little bit. That is creeping. That demand is creeping. This area is almost filled out, which is pretty cool. So yeah, that demand for residential is creeping up there. I think what I'll do is I'm also going to go ahead and put some trees in that central road. Just because I think it looks quite nice. I really enjoy trees on roads. Especially in residential spaces. Especially when you have something like this. This is a beautiful view. I love that so much. It's just this wide open road with just little houses on either side. It just looks really pretty. It kind of just reminds me of... Weirdly, it reminds me of American Truck Simulator. I feel like I've driven through a lot of spaces like this. You know, the avenue in the middle, a bit of clear space on the other side, then just big buildings on the other side as well. It reminds me of that a lot. It really does. I don't know if it should. I really don't know. Definitely more demand for industrial there. We can totally do that. What I'll do is I'm going to go and add just another row of it there. As opposed to adding too much. Hopefully that will deal with things. Commercial apparently didn't need as much as I gave it. So I'm actually going to dezone all of this. And sort of keep a little bit of commercial demand here and there. Residential demand has increased. And is increasing. There are very, very few spaces around here still to be built up. So that kind of makes sense. That totally makes sense. Could we get to... We need 8,500 people before we get trains and all that stuff. But we need 14,000 people before we unlock a new area. Which is a shame, because I want this space. I want to start building down here and continuing this little road here. But apparently that's not a thing we're going to be doing. So maybe... I'll tell you what we're going to do to sort of wrap this episode up. I'm going to get rid of all of this. And I know what you're thinking. I know you're sitting there going, whoa, Seldon, it's getting crazy up in here. But you know me. I like to get crazy sometimes. All right. Let's... Oh, I'm going to run that quote into the ground. All right. So let's just do this. That was 11. That was not what I wanted. Let me go 20 units. And then let me go... Let's do a fairly small roundabout. So that's 10, and that's 10. That's 10, and that's 10. I said fairly small. I meant sort of medium-sized roundabout. This is medium-sized for me, by the way. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Medium? Really? A bit big. But, you know, sometimes I like it a bit big. I love me some big roundabouts. Oh, yeah, right there. Okay. I've tried like 5 times to record today, and they've all not gone well. I'm a little funky. Let's do that. And let's do that. So this way, traffic's going to be able to flow in here pretty well. So if I do that, and I do that. We get a beautiful little connection there, which is great. That's going to make things so easy for traffic. It flows into this roundabout, which is going to be turned into this. So that it can flow around at a decent speed. And also so we don't have to deal with traffic lights. And then what I want to do is this. I'm going to bring this road over here. Also currently fighting hiccups, which is great. Gotta love hiccups in the middle of a recording. That's beautiful. Gonna bring this road over here temporarily. Because I would much appreciate... I would very much appreciate this space down here, but unfortunately we can't get that, so... This is what we're dealing with at the moment. Let me get rid of those power lines. I don't think we need them. No, we do. Really? That's surprising that we need those power lines. That's really surprising. I guess I could probably... No, adding parks there probably wouldn't help. That's really surprising. Oh, great. I've just discovered something else. So, not in the game. I'm in real life. So, I was saying there a second ago, I was fighting hiccups. Well, as it turns out, I didn't quite realize, but my position that I was sitting in was with my foot beneath me on my chair. Yeah, I'm one of those people. As it turns out, I may be on the brink of developing some pins and needles in my foot. So, that's going to be fun. If you don't know what pins and needles are... I mean, I assume you probably do. It's that weird feeling you get when you've sort of like temporarily cut off the blood flow to a part of your body, and as it's flowing back in, it feels really weird. It's that. Yeah, except it can be quite painful in certain parts of your body. I think I'm okay. My foot is, I can feel it again, so we're fine. But yeah, it can be a little bit uncomfortable. In this case, I think I'm fine. Also, this traffic flowing about here is pretty cool. So hopefully, we'll see a lot of traffic using these roads. There is definitely some traffic heading out that way, which is pretty cool. This roundabout seems to be working. Big demand for industrial zoning. So let's give you guys another little strip of it just there. And a little bit for commercial. So I guess what we'll do is give commercial just... I guess up to the... You know what? We're going to do it in strips again. We're going to give you a strip up to there. And hope for the best and see how that goes. This space in here, though... The good news with having this little thing in here, this avenue... Although it's probably temporary... It does mean I can technically go ahead and just add another little road of housing there, which I'm quite excited to do. I'd quite like to do that. So let's grab you and just do this. So it's going to go to... Oh, that's a little bit close to the thing, though. Yeah, that's a very small junction there, but hopefully that'll be okay. I'll send that one to but that point and then go to this road and do something like that. So just a little something like that to add a little bit more zoning to the area. Get rid of the power lines for just a second. Gonna have to change those up completely, aren't I? Where could I... I guess I could run them across somewhere in there. I know I could put a park in that space to connect it all up, but I really don't want to. Do that and that. There we go. It's a really ugly connection, but it'll do. Obviously, it's temporary, so it's gonna be fine. Let's get some residential zoning into this space then. So, just paint all of you guys in, paint that one in, and that should be good. That's another little space of residential zoning that people can move into, which is going to make that a really nice and pleasant little neighborhood. I really love how this area is turning out. I know it's messy, but that's intentional, you know? That is intentional. It's got that kind of messy, intentional look to it. And I'm happy with it. I am. I'm legitimately very happy with this. I also like that there is a decent bit of traffic using this road and this roundabout, and... I mean, generally, it looks like traffic is flowing much better with the massive sort of culling that I did to the industrial space. As for... I mean, commercial zoning, it's not really... It's not really growing all that much. This guy's empty over here, which is great news. So I'm going to go ahead and add just another block of industrial zoning there. And, I mean, incineration is not doing amazingly, that's for sure, but it's doing something. I guess for the rest of the industrial zoning, what I'll do is I'm just going to fill up that space and hope for the best. I think I'll take two off of the end there. And that might be okay. I'm also going to do a little bit of commercial zoning just there. And I'm going to fill up that space, I think. Just like that. And I'm going to have that gap either side of the little pathway there. And hope that that's enough to not horrendously pollute the commercial zoning. I also think I'm going to take it off of this road here. Because I don't think it really matches. So we'll see how that goes. I am intentionally... I realize there's a lot of pollution here. And leading right into this zone here. So putting these guys right next to industrial zoning might be a bad idea. It's possibly a bad idea. But, you know, we've got those guys building up. We have a big demand for residential zoning. Lots of people using the roundabout here, I assume, to get into the main part of the city, which is pretty cool. I kind of like that. I like how this has turned out. I like the whole space, and I'm quite proud of it. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'm going to leave it there for today. Things are going reasonably well in Vanilla. Things are developing. And, yeah. So, I'm quite pleased. That's about it, really. That's about all I've got to say about that. So, thank you kind of for watching. This has been City Skylines and the Vanilla Let's Play. I believe it's part 3. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Hello and welcome back to City Skylines! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Vanilla, that is both the series and the city, which I suppose is more of a town at this point, but that's fine. It's doing alright, we have 6,849 people. We get more stuff at 8,500 people, which includes trains, which I'm super excited about because it would be really nice to get a train, cargo train terminal into here, even if it is just temporary, you know? That'd be real, real nice. What I'm also going to do is buy this tile here because I'd like to do something about this traffic at some point. But I think my focus for today is going to be on making sure that we can get a lot of money and making sure that we can hit our milestones, because milestones are pretty important. They are. Even though, you know, the game is, it's a simulator, it's a city simulator, and it's a beautiful game. You can make beautiful things. This is vanilla, so we don't have those mods. We don't have creative mods in the slightest. We don't have anything. No traffic management mods, no nothing. So what we have to do is make some serious bank and then get in to making everything look pretty. So what I'm doing at the moment is going ahead and capping off the industrial zone a little bit with some roads that are going to cut through the space. I'm also going to go ahead and do something similar just over here. I'm going to pause while I do this though, because this is a chain. Oh, wait a minute. No, that's fine. That is completely fine. We're going to cap some roads off there. I'm going to get rid of a little bit of industrial zoning, about 4 tiles worth of industrial zoning from there. And these pathways in here are also going to go. And that's because I want to try and help traffic a little bit. So what I'm going to do is that road's going. Not completely. I'm going to put them back in to a point, that point specifically, so that buildings can still be zoned on these roads up to the same space that they were before. But this way, traffic has to come into the city a little bit, and it also means that we don't have these roads connecting directly to the sort of avenue entrance. I'm going to get rid of that road completely because there's not really anything I want to change with the residential space here, so get rid of you. We'll keep that park over there. And I'm just going to go ahead and expand the commercial zoning a little bit, just right up to the road that I've put through that whole space. So there we go. That's going to be absolutely beautiful. Hopefully. Hopefully that'll help traffic, because most of this you're seeing here is industrial traffic. And there are other solutions. I've toyed around with the idea of putting a roundabout in here or some kind of junction that'll take industrial traffic over to here. But I don't necessarily want to do that. That's not really something I'm interested in doing. What I will do, though, is go ahead and just fill up all of this space with more industrial zoning. Just every bit of it, like so, and all of that too. Those guys are going to need some serious water as well. So let's just bring that over to there, and over to there, and bring you over to there, and bring this over to that spot as well. Okay, so those guys are all going to have water. We do need to demolish that building. We are having some serious garbage collection problems. That is quite simply because we absolutely need more garbage incinerators. So we're going to go ahead and get another one right there. And we can't afford another one, unfortunately. They are 30,000 each, so we're going to be waiting a little bit for that. But another incinerator should absolutely help the city. So let's hope that that is the case. As for industrial traffic, I'm really not sure what to do with it. I'm really not sure because, I mean, it's cool and all that it's, you know, so keen to get where it's going, but we just have so much of it. And I really don't want to make an ugly little junction here that's going to take industrial traffic over to here, because not all of the traffic's going to be interested in using it, so I don't know. I think what I will do is put another bit of a focus on, these are $10 each, so that's fine. We'll just sort of throw them just in like this, just to kind of make this space look nice. And I know this isn't a creative focused series, but just a few rocks here and there to just spice the place up a little bit, you know? Just to get some rocks into detail and all that stuff. Looks kind of nice, especially with that little kind of hill thing we have going on. These just look interesting and like a bit of decoration, even if these are just temporary. Again, a lot of what we're building is possibly temporary. This little suburb, maybe less so, because it is a little bit further away from the initial battery of buildings that we had. But, you know, it's very possible that in a million episodes' time, I will want to change a lot of this. So we'll see. I'll put that big tree in there. I'll put a slightly smaller version of that tree in there. I'll get one of these trees just in there and one of these ones in there. and just get a few trees out to make the area look slightly alive. And even that is just a nice little touch. And I like it. I do. I'll put a couple of trees just there as well. One of those and a nice big tree sort of there. I think it just looks good. You know, just a little bit of vanilla decoration. You don't have to have a million and one mods in City Skylines to make something that looks kind of cool. So there you go. Even though this area is quite bare, we can fix that eventually. What I will do, though, is turn off snapping on you, and I want to just bring a little sort of... I'm going to say a dirt path, I think. Sort of just around the back of the school. Just sort of like that, and then maybe... kind of come across there, perhaps? I don't know, maybe it just continues sort of along here. Because there's not really much else I can put into this space. So bringing a little dirt path through there is kind of cool. I kind of like it. You know, it's a little pathway that people can take to get home a little easier or something. You don't have to go on the main roads or whatever. I can also put some trees along it, which will make it look like it belongs a little bit more. So do that kind of thing. Get a couple of these trees just along this little pathway, which I think looks nice. Education, because we have 1,400 people interested in high schools. This can only hold 1,000, but I think a high school might be a really good bet. It would also be nice to maybe throw into this neighborhood over here. I think that's something I'm going to do. I'm also going to get rid of this road here, because as you can see, traffic backs up a little bit because of these tiny junctions. So get rid of these guys here and bulldoze their buildings, and then just connect this road straight through like that. I feel like that's fine to have. That's a decent connection. It kind of makes sense. Little tiny junction here. But other than that, I think this kind of makes sense. It stops traffic from backing up horrendously at this point here. So we'll do that. I'm also going to go ahead and I think just bring this road through here. Because I could maybe, just maybe, put a high school on that. Which I think would be kind of cool. Because it puts it right in, yeah, it puts it right in the residential space. And right next to a whole bunch of houses. It's a nice neighborhood, I think. So I quite like that. What I'm also going to do is just de-zone sort of the back few bits of these guys' houses. So that I can decorate the high school just a little bit. Because it isn't the most pleasant, let's be honest. You need to get out. There we go. So that guy's house has been got rid of. You can go as well. And these trees all need to kind of go as well. There we go. So let's just get those guys out and get rid of that tree. Get rid of that tree. And a couple more of the trees just there. And what I'd like to do... Oh, that's a little buggy. Let's maybe fix that. And just bring this road to about there instead. Maybe a little bit further. Can I get it to go just perfectly to the end of... Yeah, there we go. Much better, less buggy, which is what we want. So, what I'd like to do is come in with some trees, and I'm just going to sort of plop a couple of trees at the end of the road and just here and there, just to make that road a little bit nicer. I think a couple of rocks could be really good too. Something like that. Get a nice big tree in there and in there. And a couple of these slightly lighter trees along the pathway as well. Just make it look nice, you know? Just a little bit of detail. A couple of rocks could go in there. I think what I'll do is I just want to very loosely line this side of the school with some hedges to make it look like it does have an actual end to it and isn't just a big patch of concrete that someone's abandoned, because it looks a little silly as it is. So just do this kind of thing the whole way along the side of the school. I just can't help myself, can I? Seriously, I start up a vanilla Let's Play series and we're building something. We're just doing a little bit of design. I really can't help it. Unfortunately, this thing I'm doing with the hedges is going to sort of just have to end here because there's a big area there I can't do anything with, so that's unfortunate. I'll put a tree at the end, and I'll put a couple more trees just in here and there to make it look a little bit more built up. This will look pretty good once there's some houses built in front of it as well. But yeah, I think that's quite nice. I do. I think that looks... You know, it's simple, but it's effective, it does what it does, and more to the point, that gives us more education for the entire city, which we're going to need, because we do have the ability to put in some high-density commercial and high-density residential and some offices, but we don't want to do that yet, because we don't have anyone in the city that is necessarily highly educated, so we're not going to bother with that just at the moment. We could also look into putting a roundabout here, but I kind of like the little four-way intersection. It is inefficient, but a roundabout would be even more inefficient because we'd have to use the highway roads, and you can't do those in a small scale, which this is. And these would work, but again, they're a bit funky. So basically, we're going to have to stick with this. Like I said, if I use highway roads, it won't work. If I use these roads, it's going to create a bunch of traffic lights around the roundabout, so we're not going to bother with that. And immediately, so many people going to school. That's so good. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to turn on the day-night cycle.